डियर लार्नर, वेलकम टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल लर्न विद जॉय एंड लेट अस कंटिन्यू विथ माई वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग जावा प्रोग्रामिंग पार्ट 10. द करिकुलम इज मेनली डिजाइन फॉर ICSE क्लास 9 and 10. हाउएवर इट विल ऑल्सो बी हेल्पफुल फॉर प्री यूनिवर्सिटी एंड यूनिवर्सिटी कोर्सेस. दिस वीडियो कॉन्टेंट्स एरे, रिकैप एंड प्रोग्रामिंग स्टाइल, conditional statement, loop, exception handling, input from command line, mathematical function. Now let us look array once again. An array is group of same type variable that share a common name. Now how it is declared? Declaration is type variable name brackets int variable name a1 bracket equals new int 3. This is array of 3 integer elements. We may also declare like type bracket variable name. This is a BlueJ interface. Now this is the editor, the code where the code is written, public class test and public static void main string para. Now here we can see that we have written para instead of args, nested for loop, an integer j equals I, j less than equals 5, j plus plus, and system dot out dot println star. Now let us see what it will produce. It will produce any output at all, or it will produce an error and etc. Now let us see. The output will be reverse pyramid, as we have already described in my previous video, while programming pyramid and reverse pyramid. Now I want to describe here, because string args are basically string of array of strings. So array of strings, we have discussed in our previous that array can be defined in two following ways, that is a1 bracket int a1 bracket or int bracket a2. Now in this here string bracket, we may also write string para then bracket. Now come to the point para. The args is actually, we are familiar of telling arguments, that is shortened to args. You may write para instead of args, you may write anything instead of args. Anything, I must say maintaining the syntax, that is the string para is also syntactically okay and it will produce the output here. Now so one thing we have seen, that the string args, which will be substituted with string para, and it works fine. And here the string args, that is array of strings. Okay, now let us see multidimensional array. Multidimensional array are actually arrays of arrays. Two dimensional arrays, if we defined with 3 rows and 3 columns arrays, it will be defined with the following syntax. Okay, now let us see how the program is related to this two dimensional array with. Now let us consider the program of printing two dimensional array. Here public class dArray, class static void main string args, and int two dimensional array matrix initialized with 1, 2, 3, that is 3 rows, 1 row, 2nd row, 3rd row, 3 columns, 1st column, 2nd column, 3rd column. Now let us, we have to print this two dimensional array to our console. Now let us see for int I equals 0 to 3 I plus plus and j is also 0 to 3 I plus plus and system.out.println here is bracket for taking the output with closed table format and actually the value will be printed here I plus I and plus j and the value of the matrix that is the matrix array we have defined I and j ith and jth value that is this cell value. This cell value is look like 0 0 0 1 0 2 1 that is this is row and this is column. It will produce output like this. We have compiled it using BlueJ and the output is 0th row 0th column. First is I equals 0, so 0th row and for I equal to 0, j equal to 0, so 0th row, 0th column, the value of matrix 0, 0 will be got printed and that is why 0th row, 0th column printed with 1 and similarly 0th row, ith column, first column printed with 2, 0th row, second column printed with 3. Now, let us modify our programming to print only the diagonal element of the two-dimensional array. So how it you have to use an if statement that is if I equals to j. The nature of diagonal element is the row equal to column that is 0 0 1 1 2 2 3 3 etc. So if I equals to j then it will be got printed otherwise it will not be printed. So look at the program once again. Now telling once again that the nested for loop for I, j, two dimensional matrix with three rows and three columns, the diagonal elements are 1, 5 and 9, the index is 0, 0, 1, 1 and 2, 2. So the programming should be, we have to consider I equals j, if the I equals j true then the following code will be executed otherwise it will not be executed. Now the output is here that is 0th to 0th column the value. Now here is the most interesting that we have to take a command line input we print it and simultaneously we will use a mathematical function and after using the mathematical function the value will be printed. So first look at import java.lang star that is if we are to use some mathematical functions and etc. So we have to import the java.lang. Public static first, public static void main string args. Here, this part is written differently from the previous one. Previously, we have written that string bracket and then args. Now, here string args bracket. No matters. But I have written here it intentionally to describe how we will take the command line input as the array element. Now int first arg we have defined an integer value what try first arg integer parser int args 0. Now this is what we have discussed array of strings. Now args 0 this is a string. Now if it is a string then how do I assign with the integer value? So there is a function required %, which convert which cast the string value to the integer value. Now system.out.println your input is first arg that is the command line input, what we have given will be printed here. And to print the square value of the value we have given in as input. Now this is a mathematical function math. We have already been discussed math.pow, that is power, first arg is 2. This is error function system.out, like system.out.println. This is system.err.println. argument value must be an integer. Now let us suppose in command line we give some input of character or string, then the mathematical function will not applicable. So we have given an error condition, then it will be exited. Now let us see how it will produce an output. Now after compiling, if we want to run, and this BlueJ interface will ask you to give a value which will be passed as command line argument. So we want to give 5, so we have to give 5 with double quote here. If in other program, if the command line arguments takes more than one value, so the value will be separated by comma and all to be covered with double quote. That is, etc. Pressed OK. The output will be your input is 5 as usual. The 2 power of 5 is 25. The output will be looked like this. Next, if we intentionally we give here hi, it is in the double quoted, alright, no problem. Now if we press OK, then the program will give you the output argument hi must be an integer or consume more time. Here the exception will occur and it throws the error. That here is the exception part. If we have give some input which is not an integer, exception will be caught here and the program will be exited with it is exit code, but it will be printed with this output. Okay, now here whatever we give the input should be covered with double quote and the output will be look like here. And if we want to give multiple input, here multiple input is not possible because the program structure, because of the program structure. If you want to program it with some other type, now you may convert this program to take two command line arguments, that is input value and the power. By default we have squared, that is the 2 power of 5. You may take the input value here, that is you want to find out the 3 power, that is cube, then you may got input 4 and here 3. Okay, now let you do with your as it is your homework. Now the reference you may read Java book, you may go through internet, etc. Now thank you. If it is helpful, then like, share and subscribe. Thank you again.